may remember that we had a carol service earlier this year. This is not the first carol service we had. We had a carol service in February. I think it was the 6th of February. And that is because we were not able to have a carol service last Christmas. And you can remember why. So God is good. God has been faithful. And God has blessed us and given us the privilege to be together tonight. So welcome. Welcome to all of you, friends, families. Very glad you're here. We have a special person of mention tonight who's here for the very first time, Victoria Martin. Very glad she's here. And how appropriate it is that she's here for a service of singing. I hope you enjoy the evening. And may God bless you as we experience Jesus Christ. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. I was thinking of that word so recently, for God so loved the world. And in our English understanding, sometimes we can think of that word as meaning, well, God loved the world so much. And that would not be a wrong way to look at John 3:16. The word so means in this manner, or in this way. So this is the way that God loved the world. This is the manner in which God showed his love for the world. He gave his only begotten Son. And we're very, very thankful for that tonight. So as we sing, as we read the Word of God, as we experience Christ, may it be a fresh revelation of him tonight. Stand with me as we pray. Our Father in heaven, thank you for God being with us. Thank you for Emmanuel. And for each person who's here tonight, we have the privilege of experiencing God with us. Thank you for your great love in sending Jesus. And may he be glorified tonight because of his willingness to come in the manner in which he did. Thank you, Lord, and may you be glorified tonight for your willingness and your love in sending him. We commit the evening to you, that everything that is said, sung, and done will be for your glory. And may we all be inspired to serve you. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. You may be seated and enjoy the evening.
Here's the first song in the program, Joy to the World. The Lord is coming. Joy to the world.
Nature. Genesis 3:8-15. And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day, and Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees. Then the Lord God called to Adam and said to him, "Where are you?" So he said, "I heard your voice in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself." And he said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you that you should not eat?" And the man said, "The woman whom you gave to me to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I ate." And the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this you have done?" And the woman said, "The serpent deceived me, and I ate." So the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, you are cursed more than all cattle, and more than every beast of the field. On your belly you shall go, and you shall eat dust all the days of your life. And I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel."
If you're able, you may stand together to the same old-fashioned.
Come and behold him, born in the seen of great height. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, the Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end. Upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth, even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this.
It seems to us a child of hope is born.
Angels, we have heard the noise. See, be seen, behold the blaze, and love. 2, verses 1 through 11. Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east of Jerusalem, saying, Where is he that is born, king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him. When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes and people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah. For out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel. Then Herod, when he had secretly called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star had appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem, and said, Go and search diligently for the young child. And when ye have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. When they had heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh.
Stand one more time to sing.
next song we'll be singing is O Holy Night, a favorite of many of ours, I'm sure. And I really like really enjoyed the last two choruses of this song, particularly in how it calls for a response from us. The second chorus and the second verse talk about us beholding our King and bowing the knee to Christ. The third verse talking about us proclaiming Christ's glory and his power eternally, I suppose, as we worship Christ as he came to earth. When he actually came to earth as a baby, he should call us to those responses, bend the knee to Christ in worship.
Shining, it is the night of So And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There shall be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away. Then he who sat on the throne said, Behold, I make all things new. And he said to me, Write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said to me, It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give of the fountain of the water of life freely to him who thirsts. He who overcomes shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son.
In all hail the power of Jesus' name.
From eternity came to earth and became a little child. battle like this. What a love that caused him to do that. A helpless child, totally dependent on others to feed, to carry, to nurture. That's our Savior, our Lord. What a God we serve. What a Savior. And as we sing at the end, crown him, Lord of all, for he became a little child like this because he loved us so much. He grew up, he died for us, he ascended, and he's coming again. That's the message, isn't it? Wonderful, wonderful story of love. Nothing exceeds that. Thank you so much for coming and sharing in this evening. Beautiful singing. Just about lifts us to heaven, doesn't it? To sing and hear this hymn. Thank you, friends and neighbors. So glad to see all of you here. And you don't need to rush out. There's some lovely sprouts over here. I think there's even some huge pies. Stay and enjoy the food, the fellowship, and most of all, keep looking up. Our Lord is coming again, and it may be tonight, it may be any day. Let's be ready and meet him. Maybe you'd stand with me as we close this. Father in heaven, we thank you so much for this evening together. Thank you for the joy. That you bring, Lord, that message of peace that the angels brought to the shepherd is for everyone who comes to you in faith. Lord, we thank you so much for this wonderful story of the Lord. And for this evening that we can share this together, thank you for yours. And pray you'll keep watch over us as we go on from here. Thank you for the food that's been brought in. Pray you'll bless it to our bodies and bless us and share with one another throughout the evening. We commit each one to you and your love and care. Now let's all together pray the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.